In the early morning sky above the islands of American Samoa, we see majestic animals with over 3-foot wingspan soaring among the treetops. At first glance, they appear to be birds, but they are enormous bats. They hang from branches, often by 1 foot, with wings wrapped snugly around their bodies. These large fruit bats are also known as flying foxes, due to their fox-like muzzle and small pointed ears. With their long tongues, they lick nectar from flowers and bite through hard fruit skins with sharp teeth. Two species of fruit bats are found in American Samoa. Both are similar in size and shape. The social white-naped fruit bat, called Heafanua, or fruit bat of settled lands, because it's often seen foraging in villages or agricultural areas, has a dark brown face and body, and a tan or rusty nape, and forms large daytime colonies of up to hundreds of individuals. These fruit bats depart in search of food at sunset. In contrast, the Samoan fruit bat, called Peavau, meaning fruit bat of the forest, because this species searches for food mostly within the rainforest, is distinguished by a pale silver-gray face and crown, prefers to roost individually or in small groups, and forages more during the day. Fruit bats play a vital role in the ecology and survival of rainforests by dispersing seeds and pollen. Bats disperse seeds by either eating fruits with small whole seeds and depositing them in their droppings, or by spitting out or manually dropping larger seeds in pieces of chewed up fruit. Fruit bats cross-pollinate plants by transporting pollen from one flower to another while searching for nectar. Scores of plant species in American Samoa are commonly utilized by people. Many of these plants depend on fruit bats for pollination and seed dispersal. The biggest threats to fruit bats are strong storms, illegal hunting, and habitat loss. Natural threats, such as hurricanes, cannot be prevented, but human threats can be. Through education programs and regulation, hunting has decreased substantially. And although some forest has been lost to development, large tracts of land, such as in the National Park of American Samoa, protect fruit bats and their natural habitat. The Inventory and Monitoring Program monitors fruit bats in the National Park of American Samoa. Monitoring focuses on determining the status and long-term trends of bat populations in the park. While some roosts can be observed by land, others found along the park shoreline must be observed by boat. Long-term monitoring is critical for documenting bat population changes and identifying environmental stressors. This information can aid national park managers in making decisions about park planning, assessing the need for further protection, and improving our understanding of these unique and threatened winged mammals, which are inseparable from the Samoan skyline.